Hey everyone, welcome to the Apocalypse Rescheduled podcast show. This is episode 30. What's the name?
Morbidly a Beast is the band name of the week. Morbidly a Beast.
You remember when we uploaded this thing onto YouTube?
We named it after Thomas.
Yeah, you did it. Good job.
Hey man, I know. It's a whole thing. I gotta download the Hangout and then put the audio over it and then...
Yeah,
it's no work at all. But I just
you fucking idiot. All right.
You know what's pretty great though is Five Guys.
Yeah, Five Guys sponsored this episode by being great. They didn't give us any money, but
or food, nothing really.
Nothing they really. They just gave us good experiences when we go there.
Honestly, not a single employee has acknowledged the existence of this podcast in any way.
I don't think an employee period has ever. Acknowledge the existence of this podcast.
I work for a place and therefore am an employee.
Yeah, my brother's an employee of things.
No, I don't think so.
Okay, that's fine.
You nailed it.
You're both
you
wrong.
Figured it out.
Nah, man, their grilled cheese is pretty good.
Come on, Corey, are you really going there for
I'm
a
I'm going to walk into
sandwich?
A burger joint and order the grilled cheese.
It's good, man.
Fucking kill yourself.
And I'm not eating meat.
Well, are you eating like a fucking bag full of peanuts?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, he steals like 3 pounds.
Well, then fine.
Of peanuts.
Then now at least there's a reason for you to be there. Because if you're just going there to get the grilled cheese, then fuck you. You can just do that at home.
Get like a BLT or something, man.
Like 3 days ago, I talked about how I ate like a half a pound of peanuts or cashews or whatever it was.
No, you said you ate a pound. Yeah, like you think you said you ate 20 ounces of peanuts or something.
Oh yeah, that's what it was, 20 ounces.
And I said, that can't be good for you. That's got to be way too much salt.
Let's see.
And if anything, you already have too much salt.
It's not really that much. Let's see, how much is
it? It depends on if they're salted or not.
Oh yeah, it's a lot. It's like 1,000 milligrams.
Oh no. 1,000 milligrams is only like 5 times as much as you're supposed to have.
That's a whole gram.
It's actually 24%. Of your daily recommend.
No, nope.
Daily value.
Isn't your daily recommended like 220?
Well, it says here 100 milligrams is 4%. Maybe it's like not as salted as you think it is.
Maybe you need... I can't type. Dietary guidelines by the CDC. You guys cover it up while I pretend that I'm learning.
I mean...
Okay.
I've never really understood.
How much space does a gram of salt take up?
Yeah, that's the thing. When you start talking about milligrams, and you're like, how do you even? But anyway, wait. The recommended dietary guidelines, and Thomas is echoing. it's recommended that we consume less than 2,300.
Yeah. See?
Grams or milligrams?
Milligrams. Grams? Eat 2.5 kilograms of salt a day and you'll be fine, Thomas.
You know, a whole pound, basically.
Basically, wait. You'll preserve yourself so sufficiently that like your body will last for 10,000 years. Though not
you won't be alive for any of it, but it'll be last. It'll
you'll
last.
Be dead in
you'll
an
be
hour.
Made of high blood pressure. You'll just get cut and it'll just fucking spew out. Just is erupt. That what happens?
What? No, that's absolutely not what happens.
Well, it's cool that if it did.
However, the average sodium consumed is 50% more than that.
Is it really?
Yeah.
God damn.
Here's the thing, Corey. Basically, we decided that we would take all the fat out of stuff and replace it with salt and sugar. And consequently, everybody ate way too much salt and sugar. And then it turned out that those were actually both much worse for you than fat ever was.
The thing is, sugar and carbs is what's bad.
Yeah.
Like... There's more healthy fats out there.
Yeah,
than,
but that was all sugar propaganda. The sugar industry actually had a whole bunch of propaganda, and then basically they tricked everyone. It's not a super.
Well, everybody's gonna die.
Yeah, I mean,
so
yeah.
Who cares?
You got to die from something, and there's only really two things at the end of the day: your heart fails or cancer eats you alive. So you know, pick one.
Or you get shot in the fucking face.
Yes, Thomas. There's the others. There's the other deaths.
It's always two things and then the other things.
Yeah, it's organ failure and cancer and then everything else.
I mean, if you think about it, cancer isn't everything organ failure?
Yeah. No, no, but everybody
dies.
It
just fails for
no matter what,
reasons.
Everybody dies from organ failure. That's basically all it boils down to.
You remember that guy, Frank?
No.
Yes. Corey's best friend freshman year.
Yeah, man, there's images of it.
I don't know.
He's like, it's weird. All his organs just failed.
Yeah.
I don't know what was wrong. He had some, like, wait, crazy fucking...
All of his organs?
Yeah, man, it was nuts. They told me, like, yeah, first his, like, liver stopped working, and then it was this, and then it was that.
Then his left ear. Every single organ in his body.
Basically,
skin cell just stopped.
Fucking memeing a dead kid. What's wrong with you?
Corey, it's basically what happened, though. It's just like 3,000 dead kids.
Yeah, but this, like, his mom showed up at graduation to receive his diploma for him.
A lot of people's moms showed up at graduation.
She was on the stage crying. So.
What? A lot of people's moms cry at graduation.
Yeah, because her son was dead, though.
Yeah, but that's
fine. No, man. Yeah, I was told by one of his friends who was talking to his mom, like, yeah, man, he just kind of started shutting down. And I was like, oh, fuck, that's crazy.
What even is that?
Well, it's just organs just stopped
working.
That is
just like, eh, fuck it.
Yeah, dude.
His body had the outlook that my mind does, basically.
Because he didn't show up to school for a few weeks, and I was
like, his body was like, well, if we're just not going to do things, then I guess we'll just stop doing everything. Oh. Kid just took a week off, and the body was like, if that's what we're going to do.
Yep, this is... go all the way. Welcome to the podcast, everybody.
Yep.
We're making fun of people that died from high school. As juveniles.
I'm not making fun of anyone. Thomas is making fun of it. So I think the kid's a cool guy. He was a cool guy. I think I still have his gamer tag on Xbox.
Saved?
Wait.
Did you steal it?
Well, like, on my friends list. Okay. I think it's on one of my accounts. His last game played was like Crackdown 2 or some shit.
Maybe that's why he died.
Maybe Crackdown 2 came out too late for him.
His body.
Thomas, you don't know. You couldn't tell me a single thing about Crackdown.
Police. You play as a police.
No.
No.
Shit.
You're not really the police.
Well, you're a like type of police. You're a law enforcement officer of some kind.
Yeah. The game's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I think you have superpowers.
There are much better like free running.
I'm basing all of my info off of an Ego Raptor cartoon.
Ego Raptor.
You basically get these orbs which give you like power up steroid things, and you just jump around like 1,000 feet in the air.
That's about what I saw in the cartoon. Yep.
Yeah, dude.
Is this week Zardoz week?
Yeah, we watched Zardoz.
Oh no.
I forgot, man.
Oh man, what a movie!
Goddamn movie opens up with a floating head, and then there's another floating head.
Oh man.
But really, the floating head was inside the other floating head.
The whole time.
No, it wasn't. It was a man.
Yeah but that guy was still inside the other head. Yeah. Like it was.
Wait, are you saying the floating head was inside of the man, which was inside of the floating head?
Well, like, the floating head belonged to the man that was inside the other floating head.
But I'm saying, was the man's floating head inside of the actual man?
Define floating.
Inside of the floating
head. No, that was... Okay, so... That's actually just the part that the studio had the director put onto the front of the movie because they thought it was too confusing. So they added that part.
Oh, they added that to clear it up. That's to make everything perfectly understood. God damn it. What?
Before the floating head part, the movie just starts with like the what are they called? The exterminators running towards the head as it descends. That was the original start of the movie.
You know what? I would have liked just the cold entrance. I would have preferred
that. And then
the
goddamn head, the head says, penis is evil.
The gun is good.
And then
the penis
vomits a whole
is
bunch
evil.
Of guns.
Let's be clear, Corey. It doesn't vomit guns. There's a bunch of people inside the mouth throwing them out, and you can see them do it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Did you not notice?
No.
No, it was super obvious that they were just people tossing really it out. Paying. Like, you can see their hands, and I think I saw a head at one point.
Oh,
it took
man.
Me a while to start watching the movie.
Here's the thing. This movie's much more entertaining than I thought it would be.
Just because what?
I knew nothing about it, really, culturally. I knew Sean Connery has his outfit and a revolver, and he's standing on the beach, and that's all I knew about the movie, other than it's science
one
fiction.
Still image.
Yeah.
That's kind of still all I know.
And then I start watching it, and I'm like, this movie's much better than I expected it to be, and it's much more interesting.
It's actually, like... It's not a bad sci. It's not a terrible sci-fi film.
The first hour of the movie is actually, I would say, good. I would say the first hour is good, maybe even really good.
Yeah.
The last 40 or so minutes isn't anywhere near as good.
Oh yeah, the whole falling action part of the plot was just It was just bad. It was like, oh hey, Wizard of Oz reveal.
Yeah, we'll discuss it a little bit more in depth. But yeah, Zardoz was 1974. It was on the slope of Sean Connery after he was Bond and he couldn't get any more works, and now he's doing this kind of movie.
Goddamn, Sean Connery looks exactly the same as he did like 100 years ago.
First of all, this movie should have been set like at least 1,000 years in the future.
Yeah.
More than it was.
What is it, like 2022 something?
It was like 2070, something like that.
Yeah, but that's basically 1,000 years from when it was made.
No, it wasn't. It was 100.
Just about.
It was like 100 years in the future.
What is an extra zero, Ben?
A lot. Corey, okay, so the basic plot of this movie is that all these people became immortal and now they're super bored with their lives. Like, okay, I get it. That's a neat idea. Don't set your movie like 100 years in the future. That means at most they've been there 100 years and they're that bored. Like, first of all, most of them were like second generation immortals. So they'd only been there like 60.
What? 2293.
Okay, 2293.
Yeah, so
I mean, but
320 years in the future.
The utopia place was just like too perfect, you know?
Right, but like,
and you'd get bored of that immediately.
It wasn't too perfect, man. They had to like work and stuff.
Yeah, but that's just boring. Fucking kids making that weird shaped bread or whatever the fuck that was.
But like, some of them had only been there like 100 years, is my point. And they were like, I sure wish I was dead.
But Ben, they don't have internet.
It's true.
Wait a minute, that doesn't... How did they not have
internet? They had the internet. It was just, they all were all on one modem.
Basically.
They were all...
56K.
Yeah, they were all sharing one modem, and as a result, the wireless speed was really terrible.
Corey, it's basically like, what's the point of having an internet if there's only 300 people?
Well, there were more than 300 people, man. There were like 3,000 in that one vortex, and there were like a bunch of vortexes, so there were like...
It's the tens anonymity, of thousands. Thomas.
Corey, you can have anonymity with just a can of spray paint and a mask. You can do that in real life. You've been able to do that.
That's more harmful, dude.
That depends on where you do it.
No, it's always going to be more harmful than just digitally posting on the internet.
No. Like on a billboard that's about to be like repainted? No, it's absolutely nothing.
But you have to go outside, man. You might get hit by a car.
Building, you're improving things.
You might get a sunburn, though.
And on an abandoned car, you're just adding to the atmosphere then.
Yeah, basically you're just turning it from like regular boring, you know, broke down whatever into like a movie set.
I don't think it's making
it
better. Just because you're making it into a movie set doesn't mean it's better.
Yeah, it does. It literally does.
I don't know. I don't think necessarily graffitiing something makes it better.
I think graffitiing a burned out fucking car that's just been sitting on the side of the road for about 3 months now and nobody's done anything about, the city hasn't towed it, nobody's like even made any effort to remove it. I think graffitiing that's fine.
Oh yeah, I'm definitely on board with this. If there's like a burnout car frame on the side of the road and it's just like rusted and burnt looking metal and somebody just walks up and spray paints.
Yeah,
like
they do like some neat shit with some white spray paint. Then that's an
improvement. Yeah, okay. I guess it depends.
Yeah,
depends
so fuck off, Corey.
I don't want it to be some garbage gangster text that says like some. Who fucking cares? I want it to be the FWO face.
We need a stencil.
Need to make a vector art version of the FWO logo. Okay.
You know, like I fucking hate that graffiti that you see. Some of the graffiti's cool, man. Like it's an art thing.
Yeah,
but most of it's just garbage words that you can't read.
It's like look at this scribbled up version of the name Josh that I came up with and put on the side of a train.
Some of it's cool though, but that the writing is all garbage. It's just lazy.
The lazy graffiti is obviously like, just stupid. But even then, I would prefer that over just a burnt up car on the side of the road because at least it's a little bit colorful.
I mean, it'd be cool if the car was constantly burning too.
Yeah, if you could, if that would be a good like
this perpetually.
Yeah, that would be a good Shia LaBeouf project.
just a car that's constantly burning for 4 years and protesting.
Yeah, you know, like the eternal flame at like the JFK Memorial in Arlington, except it's
like
a car.
The eternal flame, but with the exact opposite message.
It can be the Princess Diana Monument.
Oh, man.
Or Paul Walker.
Ah, there it is.
Good shit.
He found it.
Oh, man.
The Paul Walker Memorial. I'm down. Let's do it.
Yeah, that'd be
Get
good.
Get that funded, someone.
Yes.
Put it up on GoFundMe. Why not?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, goodness.
Remember when they were like, Sean Connery.
Thomas's car.
Sean Connery, you're a mutant. And you're much smarter than all of us for some reason.
Yeah. That was... No. We will touch teach you our technology.
And you will give us our seed or whatever.
Yeah, that's the movie starts to go downhill once it turns out that Sean Connery's super smart and secretly the best at everything. And he's gonna save society by making everybody die. That's when things go a little bit downhill.
Oh, you're talking about after all, he starts talking with the guy in the crystal thing. Yeah, I agree. That was all awful after that.
What's it? The movie as a whole, it had this weird feel like it was trying to be like 2001 A Space Odyssey, but with 900% more exposition and explanation, which really ruins the whole feel of 2001 A Space Odyssey. That's the kind of impression that I got from it.
Maybe I wasn't paying attention, and actually, I certainly wasn't paying attention.
Yep.
But why were those kids so mad?
Which kids?
Who?
Like, the village people just started rioting.
Oh, the idea is he infects them with his...
They got so mad.
The idea is that he infects them with his savagery or something to that effect. It's a new idea to them, and as a result, they don't have any tolerance for it. So, to them, it's the first time they got mad, so they went crazy with it, I guess.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. The whole movie felt like a... What's it?
Fever dream?
Yeah, a fever dream, but a fever dream about how the conveniences of our modern 1974 society are causing apathy in the youth and all this other shit. It was essentially a case for traditionalism and Luddism framed in the worst possible way.
Sort of a neo-transcendentalist thing.
Yeah, basically.
There is that sort of almost heavy-handed messaging to it, which I just chose to ignore and just look at it the neat ideas behind the fiction. And that's why I think the first hour holds up a lot better than the subsequent, 30 or 40 minutes, whatever it ended up being. When things start to break down, and you're like, then things break down, and eventually everybody... The end. I did the last 5 minutes, though, when everybody just gets shot and they're having a good time.
Yeah.
Please kill me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That's what we came here for, actually. For
they
some
never
reason.
Explained, though.
Yeah.
Why the red bikinis?
Because Arthur Finn or whatever.
Frayne.
He was just he liked that, I guess. That guy should have been more of a character. He should have had a bigger part in it.
He
should have
had
back
less
up
of a part in it. He had penciled on facial hair.
He should have had
it was
more...
literally pencil. You could
Thomas,
see.
It was fantastic.
Thomas, I'll agree with you. It should that it could be less. I would just say more or less, not the amount that it had.
Yeah.
Where he's at the beginning and you don't know anything. And then at the end, he's like, it was totally my idea the whole time, you guys. And I'm like, okay, fine.
Just remove everything except for the parts where he's coming out of that ring. The parts where he's coming out of that ring and he's actively talking to Sean Connery, at the beginning, where he's
And that's part of why I think the movie should have been set more in the future, was because the idea that Sean Connery is a third generation mutant that was genetically engineered by Zardoz, and I'm like, you did all that in a couple hundred years? That seems unreasonably short a time frame for this.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a 100-year plan.
Yeah.
Right there. So you are already out. You've already gotten sick of this thing after 100 years.
Yeah. Then they're obviously, they have no follow-through. The entire society had no follow-through. It's surprising that he managed to pull this plot off for hundreds of years and then was like, yeah, that's great. It totally worked. Now I get to die. I'm like, man, you could just, go down there and live with the people. You're the freest of all of them. You're kind of a god. You can do whatever you want.
Yeah.
Everybody else is bored to death, and you're engineering a genetic uprising. Okay.
Just take your fucking giant head into space and have a fun time.
Well, to be fair, the giant head didn't have any kind of insulation at all. It was open to the air.
Nope. Yeah, that was pretty bad.
Although they did say that they had gone to space and found it boring and just come back.
Yeah, they're like, they got it like, I don't know, what, like what, just like 3 AU out from Earth, and we're like, ah, fuck it. Ain't nothing out here. Fuck this.
That one woman hates Sean Connery.
Nobody told me space was big and empty.
That one woman hates Sean Connery. Yeah. And then, like, he literally just shows, she runs up to kill him, and he's like, you're in love with me now. And she says, yes, I am. And then that's the end of that.
Yep. And then they sit in a cave and rot.
Yeah. Well, that was...
relationships actually work, though.
It's true.
I didn't... Yeah, and then there's, like, the orgy part where he gets everyone pregnant and steals all their knowledge. Like,
that's how relationships actually work, though.
The whole, like, spirit finger thing to, like, make that old guy old is fucking weird, you know?
Oh, remember when they age of five,
they all just, they put their hands out and they just, shit was weird, man.
That's a
neat
justice system for an immortal society, though.
No, that's why the first hour of the movie, like, all the setup and stuff was really neat for me.
Yeah.
And that scene was stupid looking, but, like, the ideas behind it were, instead of sleeping, we have a collective unconscious state that we share, and one person's thoughts are actually shared with everybody else, and consequentially, having, like, dangerous thoughts in that time frame are, like, a crime. I'm like, that's deep. But then, we just wave your hands at you at dinner, and you get old.
The apathetics, too, were, I guess, they were kind of an interesting idea.
I like I did like the part where Sean Connery walks in. He's like, "I'm totally going to rape these people," and he goes to rape them and realizes that they don't care and they're not going to fight back. And he's like, "Well, this is no fun," and he just stops.
What a mood killer!
Yeah,
it's no fun if they don't fight back.
Exactly.
Well, I mean, can you blame him though? He's been commanded to like rape and murder from a giant floating head for like however old Sean Connery is in this movie, 45 years.
Yeah, whatever it is.
45 years of age.
There's an early shot where he points the gun at the camera, and I'm like, there's no bullets in that thing at all, man. Like, we can see right through
it. It's a laser gun. They just shape it like a revolver.
Yeah.
And make it look and sound like one in every way.
We don't want to have to pay for music. Just use Beethoven.
Yep.
We don't have to want to
have...
Go ahead. Hey, man, it
I'm
works
just
for
astounded.
2001.
After watching this movie, I'm just astounded how someone could come up with this.
Drugs, Corey. It was the 70s.
Yeah. That's probably what it was. It's a fucking crazy movie, though.
Yeah.
I guess it was a good watch.
Yeah, I actually enjoyed it.
We've watched the worst movies. Like next week's Assassin's Creed movie.
Are we watching Assassin's Creed next week? Okay.
I guess.
I think so. Let me make sure it's out.
Let me make sure that it's possible to see Assassin's Creed.
And not like ass quality. Yeah, it came out It came out yesterday.
Well, I'll be sure rent the Blu-ray DVD from the local Redbox.
I mean, I'll just rent it online via Google's renting service.
Thomas, you might actually do that.
No, I don't have enough credit to do that. I'm going to pirate it.
There it is.
Oh, wait, hold on. Shit. Amazon. Is it free? No.
No.
Fuck Thomas, you, Amazon!
It just came out!
Give me everything I want for free, Amazon! How dare you?
Amazon's been taking too long to ship me my shit.
Yeah, they have, haven't
two-day
they?
Shipping, and it
that keeps happening
shows up
to
like
you.
6 days later.
Frequently
I don't know why.
Bought together with Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, and Sing, the animated movie of a reality show similar to American Idol starring anthropomorphized animals.
Oh, what? Yeah, I saw like a
what
commercial.
What the fuck
for
is
that
movie?
I saw a commercial
it's
for
called
that when
Sing.
It was coming out.
Yeah.
Isn't Matthew everybody like pigs or something?
Reese Witherspoon, Garth Jennings.
Look, all the people I don't want like to see.
McConaughey. Okay, Corey, he just said those names. Name one of them.
Matthew McConaughey.
Name another.
Reese Witherspoon.
Name the third one.
Seth MacFarlane.
I did not say Seth MacFarlane.
Well, he's in it.
Is he?
Yes.
Are you sure he's not directing?
Seth MacFarlane is something.
I don't want to. Yeah, Corey's directing. Right though. I don't want to.
But
see
anything,
Seth MacFarlane.
Anything with Seth MacFarlane involved is probably bad.
Yeah,
but Corey, Family Guy is the pinnacle of comedy.
It is, absolutely, 100%.
Did you see how they used that reference to make a joke that you remember? Do you remember Star Wars?
Family Guy was at one point pretty good.
Like nope. In the like early aughts, I guess.
Yeah.
Was it in the 90s at all?
It was only ever acceptable.
No.
That's what it was.
No. I think it was like...
It's never good.
2008?
Sure. Why not?
You know what's a bad show is the Cleveland Show. That's a fucking bad
Didn't
show.
Didn't that show get canceled, though?
Yeah, it absolutely did.
I mean, to be fair, lots of shows... Basically, every animated show gets canceled and brought back.
For a little while, it was the worst rated TV show on television.
Fantastic.
Well, yeah, deserved it. Why would you take one of the worst characters from a show that's already not that great and give him his own show? Like, did anyone ever like Cleveland? Was people calling out for more Cleveland?
They just made the black version.
Oh, it's not like when they spun off Frasier.
Where they go to the YouTube comments for a clip from the Cleveland show. And we'll give you a look into the mind of people who like Cleveland as a person. As a character,
Well, I mean...
You might have the exact opposite, Thomas. It might be a startling discovery.
Well, this is 6 hours of full episodes of it. And
which no one's bothered to take down.
I've watched 150,000
views and 3 comments, of which I can see none.
Wait, what?
Wait, how many views?
150,000.
Wait, did you say 3 comments?
3 comments, and I can't view any of them, so I don't know what that's about.
Are you sure? How can there only be 3 comments?
Maybe the comment thread got locked early on.
It could be.
Somebody was saying something about Bob's Burgers, I think, right?
No, but Thomas talks about it all the time.
Since someone's... I think the show... Everyone likes that show, and I don't.
I've never watched any of it.
What show? Sorry, I was watching...
Bob's Burgers?
Oh, it's fine. I enjoy it.
I don't like it at all.
What episodes have you watched?
Dude, I don't know. I saw it, like, right when it... The earlier seasons.
That might be it. A lot of shows don't get their footing, man.
Yeah, a lot of shows do not have a good first season and subsequently become better. Even Breaking Bad, the first season isn't great.
Like, I mean, I've kept up with the show, and I've got to say, like, one of the most recent seasons is actually really good. Like, the episode I just watched was two of the kids were in, like, school, and they had a mock trial set up for a class. And eventually they started doing, like, an actual trial for, like, two of the teachers, one of which is accusing the other of stealing their yogurt. And there's like a whole fucking thing involved. There's like a whole plot about it. And they're like, what's the word?
Did you ever solving finish watching all of The Simpsons?
No, I never did. I found other things to watch. It served
how
its much, purpose.
How far did you make it?
I got like 5 seasons in.
Yeah, that's a pretty good amount.
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
Did you start from season 1?
Yes.
Oh, no.
Of the good Simpsons, that's a good chunk of it.
But it looks so gross.
After the second season, it doesn't look bad at all. It looks the same.
It looks like it's from the 90s.
So?
You're from the 90s.
Animation, like, a lot of animation's so more or less timeless, man.
Yeah, not that
goddamn.
Like, you can still 30s. Watch, like, the Sorcerer's Apprentice movie or whatever, like... Snow White, they're all like ancient and they're all good. There's nothing wrong with those animations.
I mean, do people still watch this show?
What? Snow White? That's
The Simpsons?
Oh, The Simpsons.
The Simpsons.
Yeah, I guess so. I don't know. I don't know anyone that watches it, but somebody must.
Yeah, I don't know who.
Maybe the property's just too valuable to retire.
I've never seen a single person say, hey, the most recent episode of The Simpsons was actually not entirely terrible. I've never seen a comment of that type once.
Well, a new episode is, you know, palatable. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just not very funny.
It's one of those shows that if it stops, then everyone will fucking lose their mind.
Yeah,
I'm
like,
gonna disagree with you.
They're like Twinkies, man.
It's like nobody eats a Twinkie, but when it's gone, everyone gets mad.
Goddamn, 2 weeks in a row we talk about Twinkies.
Just,
I couldn't get any, man.
Could you not?
They only have them in quantities of 10, and they're not even the original.
Corey,
strawberry
I knew you wouldn't be able to buy just one. Nobody would sell you. Like I said, go to a gas station. Maybe you'll get one. Did you go to a gas station?
I don't know.
No, you didn't.
I don't know.
Fuck you. I go to the BJ's gas station, and they don't have like a
they don't have a thing. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, what do you know? The gas station attached to a grocery store doesn't have groceries inside of it. Huh?
It's not attached, Thomas.
It's I mean, not physically.
They can't legally attach it to the store in case it explodes.
Are you sure?
Corey,
no, I
there's
just made
no
that
reason
up.
Not to do that.
Well, they don't, though. I've never seen a grocery store attached to a
Yeah, you're right. Not physically attached. I get it. Jesus.
It's because they don't want it to explode.
That's not the reason.
Yeah.
I assume it's because they have to have all those tanks underground, and so they have to have a whole bunch of free accessible land that they can get to. In case
probably
they have to take it up.
Because they just bought the land later and decided to do that.
Yeah, I can see
nah,
that.
No, I don't think so.
I think there's less cases where you would be like, this is a prime spot for supermarket plus gas station. Whereas,
I mean,
we could totally put a supermarket up here, and then once you get a strong enough foothold, hey, we can double dip, get a gas station.
But established companies like BJ's or Walmart or something, they'll just do it.
Yeah, like a Walmart will just open up with a gas station in their parking lot.
Yeah.
Well,
goddamn, Walmart parking lots are huge.
Yeah, they're almost...
They're always huge. I never understand.
Well, they've got parking for like 1,000 people.
And they have 100 cash 100
registers.
100
cash
registers
and like
open.
One person open. Ever.
Yep.
Black Friday, getting like 4 people.
Oh, fuck.
At the same time, Walmart's like, okay, we're going to increase our wages and stuff, but they also fired like half the people, so balancing act. Balancing act between.
Didn't Walmart pay their people in gift cards or some shit?
Yeah, no, that's a continuing problem in like really shitty companies where they like pay people with prepaid cards that have like fines and stuff built into them, and like you can't take money off of them without paying a bunch of money to get it off. It's a whole racket.
It's an option. It's for people who don't have like an actual bank. And they don't want paychecks. That way, they have to take.
Who doesn't have a fucking bank?
Most Black poor people.
What? How do you? But is it like nothing to get a bank account? So you just have to go there.
I don't know.
Like
$25. I had a bank account when I was like 15.
Yeah, I've never understood.
Yeah,
what
but your mom helped, dude, or your dad, or something.
Well, yeah, but is there like a minimum or something?
Yeah, I don't know what the constraints are on like a bank account. Like you can get like at a credit union, having an account is the easiest thing in the world.
You
I understand
give them
that
$25 and they hold on to it.
Yeah. Like, I get that, like, a lot of banks aren't that way, and they have a whole bunch of, like, complicated bullshit in the way. But, like, credit unions aren't uncommon, so I've never understood, like, why someone doesn't have a bank account.
I mean, I guess there are people who just don't believe in banks. Certainly the Somalian guy that I work with, he doesn't believe in credit cards.
What does that mean?
He believes that systems of debt are just a construct of the human psyche, and he's not wrong about this, and that there's no actual physical trading going on, and in pure ANCAP Somalian fashion, is advocating for a barter system.
No, it's more that he just,
electrical
like...
engineer, Thomas.
you can do both.
It's more that he's just like, oh, you just keep spending without... You know, I think he thinks he's going to be irresponsible.
Sure, I can
something.
Get, like, if somebody knows they don't have good self-control, then don't get a credit card. I get that.
But he totally has self-control. I don't know. He just doesn't believe in it. It's like how my parents said they didn't believe in trick-or-treating or whatever it was.
Something. Doesn't happen. Not on my watch.
All these kids keep showing up and we keep turning them away.
When you just don't know how to phrase or have a reason to say that they don't
I just don't believe in it. Yeah, that, and then everyone's just full of questions and you don't answer them.
Yeah. You ask them if they've seen the latest Simpsons episode and you
Were
just go from there.
About something in particular?
No.
I feel like we got like 30 miles off base.
That was a segue to try to go into this Australian supermarket that wanted to pay their employees in pizza.
Oh, yeah, shit.
But you guys ruined it. It's this long-ass article that I didn't read and I wasn't going to.
What?
And now, did you see this article? It's like fucking a page.
Corey just shares
a page.
Fucking skim, you cunt.
that's the way to
There's
do
250
it.
There's 250 words here, man. I can't deal with that. That's insane.
That's like
half of this.
That's like almost two Twitters.
This other half page is just like dialogue completely. It's just, they just had too many extra frozen pizzas, and so the employer was like, hey, can you guys work overtime to deal with all this extra stock, and I'll just give you pizza? Which I think is fine, right?
Yeah, okay, yeah, no, okay. I thought he was only paying people in pizza for a second.
No, he's like, it's not like someone goes to the interview and says, I'm sorry, but we don't pay you in money, we just pay you in pizza.
I was just like, I'll take it.
Perfect. Thomas over here cutting out the middle. Yeah,
Thomas, if you could work at like a pizza place for an hour and they give you a pizza each time you work there for an hour, would you do it? That sounds like a pretty good deal.
No.
No.
And I don't know why. <That's>... Probably just because when I want pizza, I also don't want to wear pants.
But see, Thomas, the thing is if you work at a pizza place like that, oftentimes they'll let you make your own pizza. And that's dope. So, like, when I worked at Chuck E. Cheese...
Pronounce dough, Corey.
Fuck you.
When I worked at Chuck E. Cheese, I made my own pizza, and that was the best fucking thing about that.
Was it?
Yeah, about the
you
job.
Just take a pizza.
It was, he said it was the best. Thomas, okay. I'm with you. I thought okay. You were going to say it was the best, but no, he said the best thing about the job.
I was going to say, it's no, still man, Chuck E. Cheese pizza, Corey.
That was a shit-ass job, man. I should have just been shoving that pizza in the machines and not saying anything.
Oh, man.
Nah, man, place is gross. People, you know that thing people do where they like they take the paper towels and put it on top of the pizza.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
I've had like multiple to get all the grease off. Yeah. Multiple times, people would come up to me, customers. They'd be like, "Man, this paper towel stuck to the pizza," and you go over, and it looks like the pizza been sitting there for an hour. I'm like, what the fuck do you think is gonna happen? Stupid.
What? I don't understand.
They put a paper towel on the pizza and then
I get it, but like,
upset.
Why are they coming up to you? Like, it's your problem.
Because they come up to you for pizza. Anything. They literally anything, man.
I put a paper towel on my pizza and now it's stuck.
Give me a new pizza.
And you just say, what do you want me to do about it?
They want them to give you a new pizza.
No, but wait, you just give you them tokens, because that's kind of like... The way that
here,
manager
take some
ran
Monopoly
the place.
Money. Fuck off.
If anything was wrong, you just give the kids tokens or tickets. And that it was great because anything, whenever something would go wrong, you just throw tokens at their face and walk away.
It's like being a rich person almost back in the olden times. You run over a kid with your carriage and just throw some coins at the family and walk away.
And they're like, this is the best thing that's ever happened to our family.
Wasn't even really my kid. I stole him from a factory.
You gotta think about the kind of people that go to a Chuck E. Cheese.
I don't. I've never been to one.
I don't want to. I choose not to think about the kind of people that
didn't
go
I
to
try
Chuck
to get you guys to come to Chuck E. Cheese once?
I think you did.
I think Michael showed up there once.
Yeah, probably.
What if
you guys used to do stupid stuff like going to McDonald's and saying I don't like change when they handed you change and running up the business.
Yeah, that was really fucking awkward. It didn't go the way I expected it to.
Yeah, and I didn't show up for a reason.
In what way did it go any different?
I don't know, man. They just kind of looked at him like he's fucking retarded.
What did you expect to happen?
I don't know. I really don't know.
Hey, you
want to
go?
15,
you
want to
go do
Thomas?
Some stupid retarded stuff at a McDonald's you know, and see what happens?
You know what else we did? There was the Harris Teeter near the school never had any of those sugar cookies, so we brought in some chairs and we waited. And like within, I don't know, 2 minutes, it was literally no time. The manager comes out and says, "You guys need to leave."
Yeah, that sounds about right.
So, it's just, I don't know, man. I expect things to happen a certain way, like, you know, people be a good time.
Here's exactly
and then you just
what
get
happens,
kicked out.
Corey. Every time somebody does something outside of the norm at a place where other people are working, the people who are working are like, this isn't supposed to happen. I'm going to get it to stop happening. Doing whatever
well,
I can
well,
to shame them into
well, wouldn't leaving. Wouldn't that be interesting, man?
No.
If you work at a fucking fast food restaurant like your whole life, you get bored.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If
Corey,
I worked there for
bored,
like if I worked there for like
want...
a month, I would be doing stupid shit immediately.
And listen, it's not like it's harmful. You're not like shitting in the ball pit.
See, Corey,
making it more difficult
thing, though,
for me.
You're making the day longer. Is what you're doing. Cuz monotonous work is like like a third of the way to sleep, basically, and you're interrupting it. They're like, Look, when it's just like one thing after another of the same thing, it starts to go a little bit faster, and then all of a sudden you got this thing happening that you got to deal with, or just experience, and all of a sudden everything's back at real time.
I don't know, man. It's a story. You just go home to your like 30 kids or whatever and say, "Hey, guess what happened? Some kid came in and threw, said it didn't like change and ran away." That's hilarious.
What happened at work today? Not much, just some autistic high schooler showed up, the same as every other day.
And then the kids will look at you and say, "Are we going to eat today?" And you'll say, "No."
Yeah. I wasn't able to hide any hamburger patties in my pocket today.
I think if you work at McDonald's, you can get all
the
free food.
I think McDonald's, you get free food, I'm pretty sure.
Chick-fil-A, you get only half.
Yeah, Chick-fil-A is half off, but like McDonald's is free. That says a lot about the quality, really. Yeah. You want some beef product? You can have a whole free beef product if you want.
Wow.
You guys see that like commercial or whatever that Grant Imahara made?
No.
Like shortly after that Pink Slime video came out, Grant Imahara from the Mythbusters made that whole thing about he went to a McDonald's plant and like
said Pink Slime.
What do you think I said?
I heard Pink Lime.
I heard Pink Slime and I was thinking about Ghostbusters too.
Oh, with like the hate juice?
Yeah, the hate juice, the pink slime, and then they walked around in a giant Statue of Liberty to put a bunch of.
It was actually just a regular Statue of Liberty, Thomas.
Yeah, but it walked around.
You use the word giant though.
Yeah,
huh?
Yeah. I mean, it was just a regular Statue of Liberty, a giant Statue of Liberty.
And then his reasoning for saying it was a giant Statue of Liberty was that it walks around.
Honestly, I forgot what I said. I just assumed that the word I used was.
Anyway, Grant Imahara made a commercial or something.
Yeah, I watched that recently.
But what was it though? All you said was that he made it.
It was just like, hey, look, McDonald's is made out of real food and meat, and it was just garbage. I don't know why I brought that up, but it came into my head.
Nothing.
We should watch Ghostbusters, man. I haven't seen that in a while.
Ghostbusters or Ghostbusters?
I'm not watching that new one.
Okay. Well, I
don't want anything to do with it.
I watched the old one as recently as I was on an airplane. When was I on an airplane? Probably in like August. So yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
I'd rewatch it again. It doesn't hurt. It's like, oh no. I had to watch Ghostbusters again. Life's over. Everything's ruined.
What?
Nothing. It was a joke.
Oh,
it's a tone-deaf joke. No,
it
wasn't.
Was it really? Okay, then.
No.
As long as we're all on the same page.
I find that pages are actually discriminatory, so...
Speaking of pages, you know what has a lot of pages? Books. Speaking of books, this article... The Ohio Library and the Mystery of the Steak Sauce Bottles.
I hate you, Thomas. I really do. I asked the kid to go find some topics, and I look in the doc, and it says the Mystery of the Steak Bottles. And I say, what?
Okay. This is a library in Ohio, okay? They just keep finding A1 steak sauce bottles. They just keep finding them all over the place in their library.
Hey, man.
Every time they go to close the place up, another fucking steak sauce bottle. There's a picture of one of the librarians. She's got... 5, 10, like 25, 30 fucking bottles in front of her that she's found in there.
So is somebody going to the library and drinking steak sauce?
They must be.
Like, what else could it be?
I don't know.
That's some special.
Maybe it acts as a good lube or something.
They're not just, like, leaving the bottles there. They're actively hiding them. They're being hid. They're, like, on bookshelves behind books and stuff.
Inside of
like
books.
On the top shelf, way back where you can't see it unless you like really get up there and look.
You know what's hilarious? If you click on the article, the woman is standing in front of the mystery section. I don't know if they did that on purpose, but that's hilarious.
Oh man, and even further in front of fiction. Maybe this is all actually just a lie.
Oh shit.
It's a cry for help.
See, this is,
it's a cry for help from a desperate chef.
This is like one of those things. If you're a librarian, goddamn, that's the worst job, most boring job ever. You know, and then all of a sudden you're finding steak bottles
everywhere. It was a really boring job, but now like it's the 21st century, so you just watch Netflix on your phone the whole time.
But that's kind of still boring, though. You get bored of that.
Yeah, but like you're getting paid, though, so overall.
Yeah. This is still unsolved. They still don't know.
How long did this happen, Thomas?
He said it's ongoing.
Oh.
It's an ongoing mystery. It's been going on for 12 years.
I hope they find some steak bottles inside a book.
Since January, it says.
At some point, somebody's going to knock over something and like a 30-gallon thing of steak sauce is just going to come flooding out. Like it's. Just
I mean,
been,
is it really?
It's just been getting. Somebody's been dumping steak sauce in like an air conditioner.
Somebody's gonna pull
somewhere.
A bookcase off of a shelf, and it's just gonna. It's a book off of a shelf, and it's just gonna like open up like one of those bookcase doors, and they're gonna walk into just a room filled with just like lines of steak sauce on the wall.
Those bookcase doors are pretty cool.
Obviously, man. Like nobody has like a real one though. They always have like just a door hidden behind a bookcase. They never have that thing where you pull down one book and it opens it.
Yeah.
Nah, man. There was that GIF on Reddit. That dude made one recently. They don't seem like they'd be too hard to make, to build.
They're extremely hard to make. I've seen it on how it's made.
Well, that show's garbage, though.
You're garbage. Fuck you. That show's a fucking gift.
No, it's not.
It what? That show's great.
That show's boring as
how
fuck.
It's made. I know. It'll help me fall asleep.
The
man's voice is soothing, Corey.
The creator of that show taught one of my classes, and he's really human garbage.
Oh yeah, you told
today
me about that.
On how it's made.
Yeah, he started a website and he just started writing articles on how things work, and then he sold his website to some guy for $5 million, and then that guy turned around and sold it to the Discovery Channel for like $90 million. And this was in like a year or two period, maybe a little longer, but it was pretty short after. And so he would always sit in class and brag about, "Yeah, I founded How It's Made," and then, you know, fucking people in this.
Like, yeah, you did, but you're like, you're still teaching here, man, so, you know, things didn't go that great.
He has a pretty cool job. He's like the entrepreneurial guy, so he just basically sits around and just listens to, like, ideas.
Hasn't Discovery Channel gone to shit?
I don't know.
Like, I think I've heard that, like, after MythBusters
left. Like the same way History Channel did?
No, Discovery Channel.
Oh, History Channel did.
No,
obviously,
yeah, like
obviously History Channel.
I'm saying like, the same way History Channel did.
Like, what's even on Discovery Channel God these damn. Days?
I don't know. I
like,
pulled it up just now.
I remember back in the day, I liked. I thought Dirty Jobs was a pretty good show.
Yeah.
I don't know. Fuck, what else? What else did they have? Shit.
Deadliest Catch.
Oh, I liked American Chopper, but I know everyone hates that show.
They had, what the hell was it?
They had Auction Kings with the Monster Mash woman.
Oh, no.
What? Monster
Thomas,
Mash
you know
woman?
The monster.
Yeah, the Monster Mash woman. Her face looks like a Monster Mash.
Oh, okay. That explains everything.
I don't know what to say, man. Like, her face looks like a monster mashed it. I don't know.
Okay.
Or like a mash of
it's
monsters.
Like, it's like the female version of Casey Neistat.
Nobody knows who that is.
Literally 6 million people do.
Yeah, like I said, no one.
Didn't they have Junkyard Wars?
I've never even heard of that.
Yeah, I remember Junkyard Wars.
That show was dope.
Yeah,
I loved it.
Ben, it was the best. Two teams, all right, were given a task like, oh, build a fan boat to race across this lake. And they just had to source their parts from their halves of a giant junkyard. And just cobble together whatever they could in a time limit. The show was
It was
great.
A really cool show. They have I might watch that because it's pretty cool. They have 11 goddamn seasons. That's a little bit too much.
I've gone to the Discovery Channel's website and there's just some guy standing in the woods wearing only overalls and a hat.
Yep.
That's weird.
let's see.
Extreme Engineering is what I watched too. I watched that. All these I've never even heard of any of these other shows.
Their website's kind of
trash.
Oh
yeah, Moonshiners, man. You remember Ben's talking about Moonshiners. You remember?
No.
Remember that shit?
No, I've never seen it.
Oh man, it's fucking crazy, man.
There's a show on here called Treasure Quest Snake Island.
That sounds stupid.
What channel had that guy that tried to get eaten by a snake?
What the fuck are you talking about?
Guy got eaten by a snake.
No, it was like a TV event where they're like, we're trying to get the snake to eat this man.
Fuck, man.
It's probably on Spike or some shit.
Probably. That sounds like something Spike would do.
I don't know. Just look it up. Just look it up.
Oh, wait. Is it the show called Eaten Alive?
I don't know. Probably. It was like a one-time thing, I think.
True stories of people who've been viciously attacked by wild
animals. This was like a lot, like this, they actually went out and filmed this where there's like an anaconda or whatever. And they went out and they're like, okay, I'm going to try and get eaten by this. And then they tried and it didn't work.
I haven't watched a lot of these shows, but I have seen the Alaska. What the fuck was that show? Anybody remember?
Alaska.
Yep.
What?
Alaska. Oh, Alaska Railroad. I mean, shows like that are, they're not bad.
Yeah, it's just this entire channel, from what I'm looking at, is dangerous or otherwise unsavory jobs, people who live out in the boondocks, and let's see, fake adventures, and then sparingly videos about animals.
Okay, which channel had the one show where it's like in the Appalachian Mountains and they go hunting like ginseng root?
That might be this channel, because what's it, Alaskan Bush People, maybe?
No, because that's not the Appalachian Mountains, Thomas.
Oh, I'm like half listening. 1,000 miles. I'm half listening. It's not 8,000 miles, Corey. That's.
I was gonna say 1,000.
Well, that would also be very wrong. It's probably like whatever, 3 or 4.
That's less wrong, but it's still very wrong.
Yeah,
it's 3-ish. Okay.
In a straight line, maybe.
Oh shit, yeah. Man! If you type it, oh, never mind. Well, yeah, it was eaten alive. The anaconda ate this man alive. Man eaten alive by anaconda. I do not want to watch this shit. Let's go ahead and watch it though.
I refuse to watch this thing I am currently watching and will continue to watch.
The thing's an hour long. Let's just skip to the end and see what happens.
He doesn't get eaten. I already know what happens.
But why?
Because he was trying to get eaten and it didn't work out. I think the snake died.
Fucking clickbaiting in like 2001.
Oh, this was much more recent than that, I thought. Must be something different. 2015. See, that's, yeah, not 2001.
Whatever, man. It looks like it's from 2001. Man. No, what I was going to say is these shows, they're not, like, I would imagine, I've never watched an episode of Deadliest Catch, but I would imagine that show's pretty entertaining to watch. Like, I could probably see myself watching it.
Yeah, but I don't care if they get the crabs or not. It's like, you're wasting, like, people are dying doing what I consider the stupidest thing ever. It's like, it's crabs, man, who gives a shit?
Yeah, but it's, you know, something that happens, and you just watch it happen.
Yeah, I know, but like...
You know, like, look, they're on a boat, and it's windy.
Yeah, I don't know who likes. I don't know who likes crabs enough to justify people dying so much.
Yeah, like people are dying for crabs so that you can go to Red Lobster. I was like,
and they're not even called. It's Red Lobster too. Yeah, not even Red Crab. It doesn't make any fucking sense.
Look, man, McDonald's needs to make their crab burgers. All right,
it's literally just feeding the person who goes to Red Lobster to eat crabs. Ironically, that's the only people.
No one eats crabs. Ironically,
if you go to Red Lobster, that's the only people doing it.
You go to Red Lobster because you don't have enough money.
You go to Red Lobster because you live in Utah and it's the only place that serves seafood for 150 miles.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, McDonald's has this meat crab. Oh, it's crab meat sandwich.
No, they don't.
Yeah, they do.
Where?
They only did it for a little while, though.
That does remind me that, like, I was watching television here and all of a sudden there was three different fast food restaurants that were all advertising that they had a new fish sandwich. And every one of them is selling the same exact kind of fish. And I was like, something happened. Something happened. I think it's like Alaskan pollock or something. They suddenly, three different like places that never have a fish sandwich now have a fish sandwich. And it's all the same fish. I'm like, what the? Did they just discover this thing and now we can kill a million of them?
I think people are under the like illusion that if they go to a fast food restaurant and eat a fish sandwich, it's healthy.
It's anything that isn't a burger.
Yeah.
I think that's what it is. Yeah. They're trying to be healthy, but at the same time, they're a fat ass.
No, it's more like I'm already at McDonald's because I just wanted to eat this fucking burger. But now that I'm here, I've realized I've eaten nothing but red meat for the past 17 days in a row. So maybe
I haven't pooped during that same duration.
Maybe I should eat something that isn't a cow.
But why?
I don't know. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense.
Because fish is healthier. So yeah, a fried fish sandwich with cheese on it will be better.
It's better than a burger with cheese.
See, here's the thing. I don't know, dude. Here's the thing, Thomas. The burger isn't fried.
I don't know.
The burger is not fried and the fish is. So they're probably about the same.
Eh.
Let's look at the nutrition facts.
Yeah, look up like fish fillet and then like, I don't know.
Dude, a fish fillet is goddamn gross, though.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they're all gross, it's, Corey. It's a dollar fish sandwich with goddamn cheese and tartar sauce. What do you want? Obviously, I mean, I'm saying, it's trash.
Like, their hamburger is much better.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I don't want to eat any fish at a fast food restaurant. I'm not super into eating a burger there either, but I certainly, like, no way in hell I'm eating a fish sandwich there.
McDonald's crab sandwich thing was like $8 or something.
Why do you keep talking about a goddamn nuts. Crab sandwich? Nobody ever has a crab sandwich. They sold it for like a week.
It's $8 though, man. Who's going to go to McDonald's and pay $8?
That's why they only sold it for a week, Corey.
Yeah. Let's see. Well, we bought it. Their hamburger is 250 calories, 8 grams of fat, 31 carbs, and 13 grams of protein. The fish fillet is 44 grams of fat, 218 milligrams of sodium, zero carbs? What?
How could it possibly be zero carbs? It's on bread.
Wait a minute.
And just silence. We're waiting for Corey to...
Oh, 15 grams of carbs.
Okay.
Oh, it has literally half.
But what about... You didn't say the calories on the fish sandwich.
211.
So they're almost the same. It's
almost the same. It's slightly healthier.
Yeah, the fish sandwich has more fat and the burger has more carbs, is what I heard.
Yeah.
And they're otherwise about the same.
Yeah.
That's not really surprising.
The fish fillets taste like fucking garbage, and the hamburger.
I don't know. I've never had one.
Fish fillet? It just tastes like nothing.
Yeah. You smelled it before?
No, of course I haven't smelled it. I don't go to McDonald's.
It smells exactly how it tastes.
Like, just, like if clear were a taste, basically.
Like, no, but it's like biting it's like an
through mass, and then my teeth hit.
It's like, I definitely ate something, but I couldn't tell you anything about it.
Yeah. But it's smells bad.
You can tell
bad.
That it's fish from the texture. Just not the taste.
It smells bad. It smells bad, though.
Well, that's just because you were at a McDonald's.
It smells like you like threw some tartar sauce on the ground, left it there for a few days, and then wiped it up and put it on a sandwich.
What the hell is tartar sauce anyway?
I don't know.
It's like mayonnaise and relish or something.
Everything is mayonnaise and other thing. Like, every single sauce is somehow mayonnaise and something else, except stuff that's ketchup.
Because mayonnaise is great.
People are overboard with it, though. Like, I used to hate it, and now I'm like, okay, it's on a sandwich, I'll just eat the sandwich, I don't care. But, like, people going crazy, eating goddamn spoonfuls of it out of a jar.
Oh, yeah, dude, I had that problem when I was a kid, man. I go to Chick-fil-A and just fucking, like, basically drench the chicken sandwich in mayonnaise and then drench the fries in mayonnaise, too.
Yeah.
There's a problem.
You'd get on well in, like, whales.
Like the animal whales?
No, yes. Corey, come on.
There's a whole lot of mayonnaise inside of a whale. That's basically like half of
France,
their diet.
Maybe somebody puts mayonnaise on. I think it's European. I'm certain of that, but I don't know which country it is anymore. Somebody put.
The rest of my family hates mayonnaise.
Yeah, well, the rest of your family seems okay.
They also, but they really like Brussels sprouts, so they got that on point.
Yeah.
How do you feel about the cauliflower?
How do they feel about cauliflower?
It's like, oh, no one gets that.
You're right.
Are you sure? It's on IMDb. It's pretty popular. It's well known now.
I was in a fucking the grocery store every day, and I'm starting to see the cauliflower mashed potato show up.
Yeah, has it
no cauliflower
down?
Should have been like the tagline for the Denizen poster.
Instead of, what did I even put? Something about
who cares?
Even houses can have secrets?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Something actual, like an actual movie would have.
Yeah, I don't think so.
It's closer to an actual movie.
Yeah.
Even houses can have secrets. That's the subtitle.
Ugh.
Speaking of fast food.
Why, though?
Burger King is going to stop serving abused chickens.
What does that mean?
Are they, though? Are they just going to say that they are?
I assume that doesn't mean cage-free chickens. I assume that means some other in-between thing.
The chickens that are grown, like, unnaturally quick, the ones that cripple under their own weight.
Oh, yeah.
They're just bred for food,
yeah.
Those ones.
Yeah, the KFC chickens.
Yeah. Doesn't the fear, though, you know?
You really
got to abuse...
You have to abuse the chicken to get that delicious fear taste in the meat.
Usually when you scare something, right, the muscles tense up. And if you kill the chicken right then when everything's tense, it actually makes for better meat.
I don't know. I have no idea. I have no idea how or why somebody would know that. It feels like a lot of experimentation would be involved.
I mean, it's a fact.
Is it?
No.
Okay. Then no. What kind of...
I mean, I don't know what Burger King's trying to do. Are they trying to, like...
They're trying to improve their image from being the bottom of the barrel fast food restaurant. They're like, look, we sell 10 chicken nuggets for $1.50, and our chickens are not as abused as other places' chickens, I guess.
Wait, is it $1.50? I thought it was $1.
It's $1.50. It was always $1.50. It's always been that.
Oh.
How did you not notice? You went there and bought like 1,000 chicken nuggets.
No. Man, actually, that's true. Man, I bought chicken nuggets so many times that, like, I just started smelling them in my nose. Like, it was weird, man. For like a whole week, all I could smell was those chicken nuggets.
As opposed to smelling them in his ears. He smelled them in his nose.
You guys ever had that happen?
No. No, I never bought so many chicken nuggets that I smelled them later on.
In my nose.
In my nose.
It seems like whenever I get like a stuffy nose for a little while,
I like, smell things I just, in there. It's weird.
Yeah, and then it becomes like clear again.
And I can smell things just, from outside my nose.
I smell things, but only one thing. Like recently, I got sick, but now for the last few days, all I've been smelling is mashed potatoes. It's weird.
Corey, that sounds like a brain problem.
Do you just have food stuck to your upper lip or something?
Have you been shoving food up your nose and that's why you feel stuffed up?
I mean, maybe. But who
What
knows?
Are you, a cop?
Exactly.
Where'd you wore it? Fuck you! oh, man.
It's weird, man.
Thomas,
yeah,
how do you feel about, I don't know, I guess we'll talk about Netflix stuff. How do you feel about the Death Note trailer?
Initially, when you
brought
it up...
the only one of us that has seen Death Note, I think.
Oh, yeah. Initially, when you brought up the Death Note trailer to me, I was like, oh, this garbage, because I just, like, immediately put it in my head with the, other live-action shit they've tried to do, and was no good. Just not at all. Like, visually, or in any way.
Oh.
But,
it comes out...
What?
In August. Go
ahead. No, finish, Thomas. Go ahead.
Fucking go, Corey!
I was going to say it comes out in the Shonen Jump magazine.
What comes
out? Yu-Gi-Oh's in there as well.
Oh, okay, so you're just... Corey word-associated something for us.
Great.
I didn't word-associate anything. I just looked it up, you asshole.
Yeah, and then just started talking. Anyway, the trailer looks fine. The only real criticism I have of it is the main character. He doesn't look as confident as he should. He looks like an emo outcast, whereas, like, in the show, he was supposedly, like, I have perfect grades, do extracurriculars, and have basically my whole life planned out very well, and I'm just a generally entirely upstanding student, and that's, like, it's just a discrepancy in character that I noticed from that. But that might just be a momentary thing.
But, Thomas, wouldn't you be worried if you got a Death Note, whatever a Death Note is? It's a notebook you kill people with or something?
I'd be the opposite of worried, because that is essentially just the best thing that you could have.
Surely not. Come on.
Ben, it's like if I found a coupon for a free gun, but the gun works fucking via magic and kills whoever I want. That's not a thing to be worried about. That's a gift.
I think I've seen quite a bit of that show.
Really?
Of Death Note?
Yeah. It was on Adult Swim, right?
Yeah, it probably was.
Then I think I have.
Well, what are the consequences in the show of having Death Note-ness?
The consequences were a detective started trying to track him down. And the detective is, like, literally severe autism. And
Thomas, you say everything has autism.
No, but this is, like, literally that. It's just, like, a fucking also teenage person who's, like, extremely pale and doesn't leave his room and doesn't
but
wear
is
shoes
a police detective?
Actively at all the time. No, he's a consultant.
He's what?
He's being consulted.
Oh.
You know, like Adrian Monk.
I don't understand. Why are they consulting with one of those, that word in Japanese that I don't know for shut-ins?
Because he's really fucking autistic in just the right way to solve crimes. It makes sense when you see it.
Well, is it a movie? I don't know. I didn't check.
It's a show. The original material is.
No, the thing that's coming out on Netflix, the only thing I might actually watch.
I think it might be a series, but I don't know if they managed to get Willem Dafoe for a whole long thing. I don't know.
Yeah, he's gonna die soon.
I mean, I feel like they could pay Willem Dafoe to do basically any length of thing, but getting Willem Dafoe to do an anime adaptation on a series seems like a harder sell than of a movie. But this is something I can easily look up. So I don't know why I'm not doing that. So let's Wikipedia Netflix Death Note and see what's going on with that.
I mean, how much could Willem Dafoe cost?
It says 2017 film.
Okay.
How much could the kid cost?
Not that much, man. He was in like that $10. David Cage video game.
Wasn't he in Call of Duty?
Yeah, well, probably. He's been in a lot of things. Like, he'll do video games, so he can't be that expensive.
But yeah, it's just a film, apparently. Which is fine, I guess.
Like, you would just kill the people that you would want to kill, like, right away, and then, like, what, nothing? How many enemies can a high school kid have?
The point is, it's not about enemies. He's severely egotistical and narcissistic and is essentially just being like, you know what, I'm basically the best person that exists. I'm gonna just fucking recreate this world with me as its god, basically. Because he literally has the power to just kill anyone at will.
Yeah, but okay, so that's...
He just starts going around and he's just like, okay, you're convicted for doing this, you're dead now, and all that kind of shit.
Okay.
Yeah,
sure.
He essentially just becomes, like, hyper-fascist dictator of the world. Or at least he tries to, that's the plan.
I watched quite a bit of anime as a kid.
If it was on Cartoon Network, you mean?
Yeah, like Inuyasha. I almost became Thomas.
Inuyasha.
No, I think you'll find it's Inuwasher.
That's not right. In your washer.
I used to call it... That's what I used to call it.
Well, okay.
I was 12, and when you had to wake up... Remember having to wake up at, like, 7?
No.
Oh, wait, I still have to do that.
I had to get up before 7.
You had to get up before 7?
Yeah, for high school?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. It was no good.
Corey, you lived further away than I did. What are you talking about?
I don't think I got up before 7.
School started at, like, 7:25.
Oh, shit, did it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Every
no,
day.
It didn't.
Corey, it did every day.
Yep.
Really?
Yes.
How did I make it to school so much?
Who knows? What do you want from me? Like, that's just a fact. I don't know what to tell you.
God, that sucks.
Yeah.
Thank God it's over.
Done been over, too. I don't know what you're having this reaction for.
I forgot, dude. You forget how awful high school was sometimes.
Yeah, I suppose. What do you think of Iron Fist, though?
Corey, have you even watched this yet?
No.
Of course not.
Thomas, you finished, right?
Yeah, I finished the whole thing.
We're doing a no-spoiler version, so...
Oh, no spoilers for Iron Fist?
Spoil it. I don't care.
Yeah, but
Well, Ben hasn't finished it, so I might as well just do no spoilers. And just talk about my impression of the show. Which is that I thought it was fine. It was just fine. The choreography is shit, and the fight cinematography is pretty shit, but the show as a show is fine.
Yeah, I got those criticisms in the first, like, 6 episodes, but I feel like it got a lot better.
Yeah, but then it stops getting better, and then it just falls back down.
Yeah, like, I haven't watched the last couple episodes yet, so
yeah.
I don't know.
It gets better for, like, 3 episodes, and then it stops getting better, and it goes back to what it was.
But Thomas, remember when there was a twist, and then they reversed the twist?
Yeah.
That was neat.
How does it compare to, like, a Daredevil or Luke Cage?
It was worse than both of those.
Yeah.
Like, significantly so?
Yeah. Noticeably so. Okay. I'd say would be the correct amount. Whether or not it's a significant amount is up to you, I guess.
It's definitely better than every CW show, though.
Yeah.
Well, that's not very hard, is it?
Yeah, no. Just to be clear, that's, like, a standard that we can work from. It's better than those. There's no acting problems. It's just the choreography is never very exciting.
I'd say it's it's average. It averages out better than the average of a CW, any CW show.
Sure.
But individual CW episodes have been better than any individual episode in this.
I'm gonna be
or at least in terms of my enjoyment.
I'm going to be real disappointed when that dragon never shows up.
It's a lot of money to do that.
Yeah, here's the thing. Like, so far I've been watching the show and I was like, okay, they're saving their budget for something, and there still hasn't shown up anything where I was like, that's where the budget went. I sure hope something happens.
Yeah.
Where I'm like, oh, there's the budget. That happened in other one of the series where like, okay, there's the budget. I see where the budget went. But this one so far, I'm like, I guess they spent it on locations?
Maybe. I guess that must be it, but I didn't feel it in their locations, to be honest. I didn't see the cost.
Of course, I don't know I have no idea what the budget for these shows are. They could be mad cheap, and we just didn't realize it.
Yeah, I mean, they definitely didn't use any big names in this one, as far as I could tell.
It's Faramir from Lord of the Rings and Finn Jones from Game of Thrones. And that's it?
Really?
Huh. What do you mean? What?
I said really.
Yeah, really what?
I didn't notice that it was the same person.
From what?
The things you said.
Yeah, it's Faramir from Lord of the Rings and
yeah.
Yeah,
I know what you said, man. I was just saying, wow. I was exclaiming my surprise because I didn't know
and
that
Loras
fact previously.
Loras Tirel from Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
Why, look, first of all, I'm not surprised at all about that, Thomas, because you didn't recognize Cottonmouth like the next day when we watched Predators.
Yeah, you should basically watch Luke Cage one day and then Predators the next. Didn't see the same actor in the same role. That's just because he's such a good actor.
Lawrence Fishburne's in that movie. If we hadn't told you, you probably wouldn't have noticed.
I know Lawrence Fishburne when
it's like,
I see
look,
him.
It's Perry White from Man of Steel, and I'm like, that's the only thing you know him from?
That is not true. I would call him Law and Order Man.
What?
And I'd be wrong.
Lawrence Fishburne isn't in Law and Order.
Wait, then who the hell is?
No one.
Ice-T?
Oh shit! Yeah, but not Ice-T. The other guy.
It's a show with no one in it.
The one that looks like an even older version of Keenan from Keenan and Kel.
I don't know who.
The hell is that guy's name?
There's a lot of Law and Orders.
I'll just have to look up the cast for every single one of them.
Is CW the one with the worst shows?
Law and Order had Black Dad from The Flash.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
And
well, I mean,
like
I suppose.
And like Sam Waterston and stuff.
I suppose it'll basically have almost every TV actor at this point.
Yeah, it's been going on for 1,000 years.
Yeah.
What did Corey just ask?
He said, is CW the one with the worst shows? And I was going to say no, because there's... I feel like A&E is much more garbage.
Yeah, like, okay, so it depends on what you mean. Like, if you're including every channel possible, then obviously no.
Yeah.
If you were to say, okay, like, broadcast television, then maybe.
Yeah, I can see it on broadcast television.
Like, I don't think, what is it? I don't even know it. Like, 28 used to be a real channel, but I don't even think they make stuff anymore. Whatever it's called. I don't even remember what that channel's called anymore. So now you have... What, CBS, NBC, ABC, Fox, and CW? That's about it, right? PBS, I guess? So, you know.
PBS.
It's not a lot of competition.
It's true.
No, man, I was watching Flash yesterday, and I think I'm done with Flash.
Oh, yeah.
You say that every single episode.
Yeah, but this time was really bad.
Yeah. This season hasn't been as good as the most recent ones.
This was really stupid. This was
yeah,
like,
the last season was a musical episode.
As, and was, not only that, it was like also a crossover episode, and it was just terrible. I was like, okay, you expect me to know any of these characters from God-awful Supergirl? I'm not going to know any of them. I'm just done with that show, I think.
Yeah.
Martian Manhunter showed up, and I hadn't seen him before, and I was like, he looks like trash.
He really did. He looked terrible. He looked like Party City, yeah.
He looks like Party City. It's like a melted Party City mask. It's like you had like a Green Goblin mask that half melted.
Oh, man, bringing it back to Willem Dafoe. Look at that.
Well, it all comes back to Willem Dafoe, really.
I mean, you gotta talk about him before he dies.
He is the man who... He's the being that preceded the Big Bang, so... It really does all come back to him.
Which is really saying something. Like, he basically didn't appear for what is it, 14 billion years, and then he shows up in Platoon, and you're like,
what wow.
He's basically Nicolas Cage if Nicolas Cage was human.
Poor Nicolas Cage.
Is Willem Dafoe human?
He's close enough.
That's a good one.
Sure, count it. Give it to him.
Okay. Yeah, let's just put it on the board. Willem Dafoe, check. Got it. Okay.
Is it really Willem?
Yes, it's Willem. It's always been Willem.
Always. Like it was never not that. Yeah, Corey, you probably need to watch Iron Fist just so that you know the characters for when they eventually cross over later this year.
Ah, that's a lot of work.
Or you could just not, because they'll exposition, oh, hey, this is blank who helps me with blank.
Look, it's clear.
And that's all you'll
getting,
need to know.
She's getting letters from her black boyfriend who's in jail. That's all we're... And look, a bullet hole in the shirt.
Shut up, Thomas. Oh, it is Willem.
And oh, hey, the nurse showed up again.
Yeah, she's in all of them. Even though it makes no sense. It's just like, why are you taking, like... a kung fu class in Chinatown if you're living in Harlem. I don't understand.
I mean, that's where you would go to get a good kung fu class, man. On the cheap.
I guess.
Especially and also, I would definitely be taking kung fu classes after all the shit I'd been through.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm not faulting her for learning martial arts.
No,
I'm just saying.
Not kung fu. Kung fu's the garbage one.
Kung fu
well,
it's
something
the
then,
okay.
Man.
There's good kung fu, Corey.
99% of it's garbage.
There's a lot of kinds of
99%
of
anything is garbage.
I would like to point out, Thomas, though, they did have a drunken master fight in this show, which was awesome.
Yeah, that was cool. That was the one fight I liked out of the whole show.
There's some name for that where, like, but, like, this drunken master guy shows up, and I'm like, this is awesome. This is, like, just like Jackie Chan.
If only he could have been recurring.
Yeah, I know.
Like, seriously, just get rid of that, make him head mook for, like, the bad guys, and then you're golden.
Yeah, okay, so if the show continues the way I suspect it will, it's like, okay, you introduced your primary antagonist, like, 4 episodes from the end, and he's, like, a nothing character.
Yep, basically.
Have you guys been to the Jackie Chan website?
Jackie Chan website? No, I haven't.
The official Jackie Chan website?
Is it JackieChan.com?
Yeah. Shit's jokes. The man is a joke. It's hilarious. He's fantastic.
The website 4chan.org, right?
No. We're all pro-chan, really, so yes.
Oh, no, he has a discography.
Oh, no, does he really?
Holy shit, he's done a lot of music.
I guess JackieChan.com. Okay.
Do you go to...
Yeah, it's a fixed-width column-based layout.
I don't care, man, but, like, if you, like, look, there's a picture of a photo album thing, right? And then there's, like, a Polaroid camera. That's, like, his photography thing is, oh, yeah, took all these pictures with photography with a goddamn Polaroid from 1980.
Maybe he made this website.
That's not what it is, though, at all.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
It's just photos of Jackie Chan from other places. Yeah. On a website with an entirely different layout, but on the same site.
God, if you go to his store, he's got a whole bunch. Oh my god.
JackieChan.com is our hole in the wall of the week.
You can buy a Drunken Master t-shirt and it's $270.
Oh man, I was about to be real hype and I was going to do it.
But what the fuck?
Why is it so much money?
How could it possibly be that much money?
He's got a link at the top that says JCD store.
Yeah, I've clicked it.
Which, by the way, put it as store. There's no reason
okay,
to try
so
and
I've,
sell
I've
your
on,
Jackie Chan
I've
design.
I clicked on the
brand.
Drunken Master stick,
is it
fight, stick figure t-shirt, which...
Yeah, that's not even that good of a shirt.
No, it doesn't. There's nothing obvious about it. Then I've clicked on the sizes. The sizes are listed as small, 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 medium, and large.
Oh, fantastic.
Why is this can't, what is this?
Everything on this website is insanely priced. Does he know how much things should cost?
Maybe he's trying to,
I guess not.
He's trying to build up like a bunch of money so he can like bribe the Chinese government and get his son out of prison or something.
He's just got a random ass assortment of things. He's got some cell phone accessories.
Flashlight.
Which there's this...
What is, oh God, what is going on with this website?
You know what I hate? I hate those cell phone keychain accessories that are like the fucking Korean or whatever. It's just a milk carton thing.
There's a $50 box of tissues.
Yeah, I see it.
I hate those shits, man.
I have not interacted with them in any way before in my life. Not
There's
even seen
There's a $700 Hong Kong police action figure.
Oh, no. You ever spent $750,000 on an action figure from Jackie Chan's website?
Okay, so like, there's these really expensive like collectible and or like comic shops in various places, like big cities. Like, I've been in one in London and New York and stuff. And like, it'll be a comic shop, but then they'll have like a whole bunch of figures and stuff. And they'll be like $1,400 figures that are these massive like statues of Godzilla or whatever the fuck. And I'm like, okay, I get the, like, those are huge, expensive pieces of plastic that somebody is stupid enough to buy, but this is just, like, a regular, like, size action figure that's $600.
Okay.
He actually updates his little blog thing.
See, there's, on his website, there's a messenger bag, gray, that costs $1,250.
What is
and
this?
And it's just a messenger bag.
I don't under... What?
There's nothing that is... all it has is, like, a small Jackie Chan design logo, I guess, emblazoned on the back. And that's it. It's just a messenger bag.
How have I
and
never heard
And it's upwards of $1,000.
Okay, Corey, what made you come to this website?
I don't remember.
You just started saying you ever been to Jackie Chan website.
He probably
said
that
before. Did the Jackie Chan website just, like... come out of the ether and insert itself into Corey's mind? Is that what happened?
Probably, man.
Oh, man.
I like his website. I'm a fan.
I'm not. It's poorly made.
You should go to the news page. It's even worse.
The news page? Oh, yeah. I got to go back to the actual
site. He seems like he's such a cool guy, though. Except he's ripping me off on his fucking action
figures.
Here's
the thing. Like, we have no reason to think that this is actually associated with him in any way.
You're absolutely
you know what we
right.
Should do.
You're absolutely right. We should make WillemDefoe.com.
No, what we should do is we should make Jackie Chan merchandise and sell it for half. We would make bank, dude.
Or we should just
what is he
steal
gonna do,
the merchandise from Jackie Chan and then sell it.
This no one knows where this shit could be hidden. It could be hidden in his ass. I don't know.
Unlikely.
WillemDefoe.com is available for purchase.
Oh my God!
But somebody's squatting it. I think
that cunt. I wanted to do that.
Well, I mean, just you know, make it a zero or something. I don't know.
That's not gonna work.
I'm gonna put the word official at the front of it.
RealWillemDefoe.com.
It'd be super official.
No, official WillemDefoe.com is not a thing.
Super official.
Neither is realwillemdefoe.com, so we can get that.
We can squat on those.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone would put so much work into making just a joke Jackie Chan website.
I mean, it's not a joke, it's just a scam.
If it's a scam, it's not a joke.
WillemDefoeDesign.com is free, so we can take that and make a fake Willem Dafoe line of stuff. Like with Jackie Chan.
I can't believe
has.
This is a real thing, though.
Well, see, if you go to his About page, it says Jackie Chan was born in Hong Kong. Shouldn't it say I was born in Hong Kong?
Well, maybe if he was making the site himself.
But wouldn't he want it to be like, hey, this is my website. This is my thing.
Not necessarily.
Okay, so
you think
he just
walks up to people and say, Jackie Chan is here?
There is a Probably. Jackie Chan diary section, which is written first person.
Ah.
And you can tell it's first person because it's in Chinese and choppy English.
I would like to read
parts
the diaries
of it are in
of
Chinese.
Defoe. Yeah.
See, I was just making shit up.
Yeah, parts of it are in Chinese.
Look at that.
There's a group called the Jackie Chan Group.
You know the Chan fam. Oh, what's in the kids' corner of
the
Jackie Chan
website? The Chan fam. There it is. Chanfam.com.
Can't believe that you would charge me $600 for a Jackie Chan action figure, Jackie Chan.
$1,200 for a bag that only says Jackie Chan on it, and that's all. That's all it is. It just says Jackie Chan.
I'm telling you, man, if we made our own, we would make bank. If I had one question for Jackie Chan, that's what I would ask. Like, why does your merchandise cost so much? And also, well, fuck it, you just choose random shit to sell. You just got home and kit.
And hire a different web designer for each page of your website.
Seriously, man. You could get a Jackie Chan bottle with a dragon on it.
For
$140.
Corey, go to the films section.
I'm sorry, everybody. This is just what we're doing now.
Yeah.
It honestly doesn't happen enough.
What's going on?
On the film section of the website, it uses a horizontally tiling fire background.
Yeah, and it just repeats.
It repeats. It's no good. It was not tested on a 1080 monitor.
I don't think anyone comes here on purpose, though.
It works.
Somebody has to.
It kind of works. I don't think so. At 120. If you zoom into 120, it sort of works.
Yeah. Isn't there a website you can go to see, like, the analytics of it?
Like Alexa.com, right? Or whatever? The Alexa metrics?
It then zoom all the way out.
Oh, man. That fire looks awful.
Yeah. And the thing is, it's not like... It's just like, instead of having like some sort of CSS thing to make it stop repeating vertically and just go to black, they just added a big old black rectangle to the ass of it. So that way it just wouldn't repeat before the end of the page. They're just like, yeah, just make it fucking 3,000 pixels tall and then it'll be fine.
I'm sorry, Jackie Chan. You're a great guy, but your website's terrible.
Seriously, pay somebody more than $30.
He probably paid somebody a bunch of money for this, too.
Oh, my God.
The kid got scammed, dude.
Yeah, and now he's trying to do it to me with those messenger backs.
Holy shit.
It's just a circle of ass blasts.
Okay, so this is the monthly traffic for JackieChan.com.
Okay.
Oh, no, okay.
It's going to either be really low or really high.
I'm going to send you the link. So it starts off at, like...
zero, and then it jumps up to three all of a sudden.
No, it's
today.
Weird. 40,000 in the month of July 2016, and then all of a sudden this year there's just like upward trend going to like 100,000.
That's probably because
so
of the Lifetime
visitors.
Achievement Award.
Yeah,
it
could have been because of the Oscar.
I guess so.
Oh god, when did somebody send this GIF?
Corey did earlier.
It's fucking. It's pretty fucking terrible.
You gotta stop, man. This is awful. I'm sorry.
Way to go,
sorry,
Jackie Chan.
Jackie Chan.
I'm not.
Yeah, no, man. That was when the Oscars were more or less. You got that Oscar bump.
Okay, so it says the who is information. The owner name of the website is So, Solon, contact middle name. Owner location is Kowloon, Hong Kong.
Yep.
Sure.
This is why you don't outsource your like any kind of design work. It's not good.
I mean, his website's up 60%, 61%. So there's roughly 100,000 other people who have seen this website this month.
Wow.
And he still lets it look like this. He doesn't give a fuck about anything.
Well,
the man's a madman.
He's done everything he needs to do, so whatever, man.
That's true. He's pretty much like the greatest human being.
But yeah, it's not like you can say that we've lost a few that you can't use as examples anymore. Like all you got left is Jackie Chan and like Mr. Rogers.
I mean, Jackie Chan's just like the least offensive, just famous person.
Yeah, sure, absolutely. Like, every one of his movies. Like, first of all, we're talking about Jackie Chan again. How many times have we talked about Jackie Chan on this podcast?
I don't know.
Jackie
Let's switch to any topic that isn't Jackie Chan.
We've talked about Jackie Chan way too
Thomas,
much.
Thomas,
ah, God damn it!
You can't even name 10 things that aren't Jackie
Chan. Yeah, that's
Chan.
The reference I was making. Good job. You figured it out. We're
what
all
even,
very
yeah, what
proud
was that,
of
you. What was that originally from?
An Adult Swim Pictionary thing or some shit.
Yeah. I think it might have been Tim and Eric, maybe.
Yeah, that might
have
been.
Tim and Eric sounds like it's right.
Yeah, and it was just a like a party game. Name 10 things that aren't Jackie Chan.
You watched any Samurai Jack, Thomas?
I keep wanting to, and then forgetting about it.
Well,
yeah,
that's good enough.
Yeah.
I mean, does anyone even remember it?
No. No one ever saw it when it was out. That's why it got canceled.
It came out way too, like, long after the other shit. The original. So, like, no one cares.
I mean, lots of people care, just... I don't know.
Do they, Thomas?
How good is the ratings? That's the thing, Corey. A lot of people will care, but not enough to watch it. Or at least not enough people with cable.
But the internet's a thing, isn't it?
Yeah, but I mean, how are you going to sell shit on the internet? Everybody got adblock.
Well, I mean, you just watch it.
Yeah, I guess. I don't fucking know.
I mean, does it have just the season 5 rating? Oh, shit. Season 5, episode 2 is rated 9.8. That's pretty fucking good.
Wow.
Yeah, that is pretty good.
And the first episode is 9.4.
Well, that might just be people jerking it off, but it might also be really good.
It doesn't show, like, how many people rated it. It could just be, like, 20 people.
Weird.
Yeah, it could just be 20 people. That's how ratings work.
This show is great, though.
Samurai Jack, the original part or the new one?
The original part.
Okay.
It's a great show. I remember as a kid, I just kind of didn't understand it.
What's there to understand, man? It wasn't like a linear story. It's just things.
I don't know, man. I just couldn't do it.
Couldn't do it.
Man, it's just, oh, hey, I wander around fighting evil, solving problems.
I didn't really believe in it.
God damn it. Bringing it back.
Echoing a previous conversation that no one's heard. You just say, I don't believe in it.
No one just starts a podcast an hour and a half in.
Well, Thomas, since Corey is just the worst.
Yeah.
What are your now even better informed opinions on the Switch?
Oh, shit. Fuck, I don't know that any of my opinions have really changed.
How much more Zelda have you played?
Double?
And you're still not tired of it?
No.
Have you beaten it?
Oh, yeah, I beat the main plot. I'm at like three quarters of the amount of total hearts you can get, and I've fully upgraded my stamina.
That's
wheel.
It?
Fully upgraded your what?
Stamina.
Oh.
Yeah, so.
So you're done.
I'm getting close to done with it in that I've got
that
like. Corey, I've spent like probably upwards of 100 hours on this.
That was one of the things that I just. Made me uncomfortable when I was watching your stream is you would try to climb up like a tower or a rock or a mountain or something, and then you'd lose all your stamina and fall back down.
Yeah, it's supposed to make you uncomfortable. It's not a fun thing.
It's just sweaty. Yeah, it's not at all. It's really not.
Yeah, no, but I've got, I started with one circle of stamina now, Corey. Now I've got three circles, and I've got a set of armor. Yeah, I've got triple the amount of stamina I did before, and I've also got a set of armor that I don't know what the hell that was. That halves the amount of stamina that it takes to do the little jump things. So I can essentially climb like six times higher than I could before.
Yeah, there was a one section where you were trying to get up to that one tower and there were like those four wizards guarding it.
Oh yeah, the lake tower.
And, yeah, that shit was awful.
Well, what games for it are you looking forward to in the near future? Like within the next 3 or 4 months?
Shit, dude. I don't even fucking know.
Like, what's been announced, even? Let's see. Splatoon 2, ARMS, Mario Kart. That's about it, really, isn't it?
Hasn't there Pokemon stuff been, like...
There's been new Pokemon stuff, which we could talk about.
Oh, yeah. What
it's
developed
It's not, like, confirmed,
that,
but, like, Game Freak is hiring.
Yeah, Game Freak
people,
is hiring for definitely Pokemon. Like, the listing doesn't say Pokemon, but it says, you'll be designing deformed monster-looking things and also items for a well-known, popular brand worldwide. I was like, what could that possibly be? At Game
Digimon.
Freak?
But they said, like...
Game Freak bought Digimon. Nobody was noticing.
It will end in May of 2018.
Yeah, that's when the contract period for that person ends, is May of 2018.
So, when would the game come out, you think?
Who knows?
Like, 2019?
So
probably like early 2018.
This is the development listing, Thomas, just to be clear, was for work on console.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it is still looking at like a Pokemon console game, presumably for the Switch. Now, the old rumor was that Pokemon Stars would be announced at, like, with the Switch, it would be like, look, system seller, we have Pokemon coming out soon. And that was just like, look, we've upscaled Sun and Moon, and there's a few more new Pokemon, and you can play the game again or something. That was what the original rumors were all about. This looks more like a full-fledged game that's being developed and won't come out for at least a year.
Why do they just want to hide this shit? Why wouldn't they just announce it? That's what everyone wants. Why wouldn't they just announce it to drive up sales for the
Switch?
Nintendo's
weird, man. Like, they don't conform to trends at all in the industry in any way. They just do their own thing, often to their own detriment. Like,
it doesn't make any fucking sense.
Yeah, their marketing is usually not super great.
Their marketing is great for not power users, I'd say.
Yeah,
like
they're
for people who are like rabidly like hunting around for all the information Nintendo, you're fucked. But for like just the average person who's like, oh shit, new console, thanks Super Bowl ad.
A good parallel is, so if a trailer for a movie or a game leaks, most companies will just say, okay, just put out the real trailer tomorrow instead of a week from now, like we were planning on doing it. Whereas everything about the Switch leaks like a month early, and they just pretend it didn't happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, but you can't confirm things, man.
The people who play Pokemon are like those information hunters, you know?
You would think, yeah, the part of it is, but the audience grew a lot last year relative to previous years. Like Pokemon, because of Pokemon Go. Like Sun and Moon sold really, really well for Nintendo overall. Even compared to like previous, you know, real popular Pokemon games. So to a certain extent, yeah, there are people that are hunting for all the information. There are people that post about it on 4chan, but then there's still that same casual audience. It's just, I like Pokemon. I want to play with Pikachu.
Yeah, I guess so. I could totally see that. You play Pokemon Go and then you're like, hey, I remember Pokemon's cool. And then you pick up like the Pokemon game or whatever. I could see that.
After they announced that like Mario isn't coming out till the end of this year, I was like, yeah. And once they said that, I was like, they're not worried at all. They're confident. They'll just put out Zelda and hope that people will buy it because Zelda.
And they
so
did.
So far, they have. So far, they've been completely right.
Yeah.
Isn't the Switch selling better? Has a better start than the Wii?
It has a better start than the
Wii.
That's
what some of the preliminary numbers are showing.
Yeah, and it has better start than the Wii and the Wii U. It's doing like PlayStation 4, Xbox One numbers right now.
People are like buying this thing just to play Zelda. It's stupid.
Here's the what I don't understand is people that have bought the Switch and haven't bought Zelda, because there is like a 5% of the market that has done that.
5%? Yeah. That's high.
I don't know either.
You're like, what could they possibly?
What are they
1-2 Switch?
Saw a video of people play 1-2 Switch and it looked fucking great.
1-2,
yeah, but they also have Zelda.
1-2 Switch looks like a fun party game. Two or three times.
Yeah, and if I hung out with people more often, I would absolutely buy it.
Oh, yeah, if we were still at the apartment, then it would make sense for you to have
it.
Yeah. But Thomas, living alone doesn't make any sense to play 1-2 Switch by himself.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Kid plays Mario Party by himself.
I did, because I always wanted to play Mario Party. That was just one of those things where, like, Mario Party always looks like fun, and I heard people talking about playing Mario Party, and I never got to do it. So
it's like playing Yu-Gi-Oh! With yourself.
Yeah, I also did that, because I didn't have anybody to play Yu-Gi-Oh! With.
You had siblings, multiple of them.
Yeah, they didn't care about they didn't care about Yu-Gi-Oh.
As they shouldn't have. You should have picked up on that.
You're not wrong.
You should have taught them
taking
the ways.
Some social cues.
Thomas, you're not wrong.
Dude, there's nothing wrong with Yu-Gi-Oh.
Except for all of it.
Back in the day.
I can see
where
you...
All right. Right now,
I can see the gears
every time
turning
I...
as soon as you started, I was like, but Zexal, though...
No, oh god, don't even talk about the show. Just like, if I see someone playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Out in the street or something now, it's just terrible.
You know,
that's not what I want to see.
Yu-Gi-Ohers.
People wore that dual disc to like school picture day, man. That was the thing.
If
that
I owned one, I
no,
would.
They didn't.
They did absolutely do that. I saw like two or three people that did that.
Dude, if I owned one, I totally would.
Your
just because it's fucking retarded.
Yeah.
Mostly just to piss people off.
Like in elementary school, though.
Those things were pretty cool. I recently watched a review on one.
Well, how cool could it be? It's a piece of plastic with more plastic attached to it.
Hey, man, you could, like, put your cards in it and then play them.
Yeah, but, like, you couldn't actually use it like it was used on the show because the cards would just
fall
out.
Well, I mean,
it didn't have holograms, Ben. You're right. You figured
it
out.
Now you kind of can.
Like, the cards would fall out.
No, they wouldn't.
Yeah, they totally did.
Yeah, well, can't you do it with like the HoloLens or something?
That's what, like, first of all, why haven't we heard anything about the HoloLens since like the last E3? I haven't heard a word about it. And it was like, this looks super cool. This is the coolest thing. This is what Google Glass should have been, and people would have bought it.
It's because it takes a while to develop things, like a long time. Yeah, but there just hasn't been news. They're just chugging along, man.
I imagine it's easier now to do augmented reality stuff. I was looking at it. I actually saw a couple videos the other day of people playing Yu-Gi-Oh! With augmented.
Of course they were. What else would you do?
That's all Corey does, man, is just type Yu-Gi-Oh! Into fucking YouTube and then just lets autoplay do the rest. That's all he does.
No, man. No, I was looking up Yu-Gi-Oh! And I don't know how I came into it, but it was on my related videos of a Halo 3 Easter egg. And then I started watching this guy's channel, and he happens to do Yu-Gi-Oh! Stuff, too.
Is this you post, like, two sentences about Halo 3 Easter yeah, eggs, and I spent, an hour looking into bullshit from 10 years ago that never turned out to be anything?
Yeah, like that cave of a thousand faces that was just a wall
texture. It just made me mad. It made me so mad.
It was just a wall texture that kind of sort of barely started to look sort of like three dots that maybe you could interpret as
everybody was looking at their 480p, CTR displays, looking at, like, look, I think I kind of see a face.
Nah, man. I was watching this other one of this other gate in Halo 2, and it was like this gate revisited and solved after like 10 years, and it turns out it just wasn't anything. It's just there. It's just like an asset that they didn't use, that they left in for some reason. Nothing. That's it.
Nothing. Turns out that was nothing. It. At nothing. All. Waste your time. Of course it was. It was a graphics glitch then, and now it's nothing.
I remember back in the day when I saw Easter eggs in games. I thought they were so cool. Now I don't give
a
fuck.
Right, but Halo was full of them, but they were real ones. Yeah. Like, look, we hit a bunch of like cave people up in the hill, and you can find them. That's a real thing. Versus this kind of looks like a face.
Yeah, like they had this one recently where it's like really, really hard to get to. It takes like an hour, and you have to do these like specific frame movements. And once you get on top of the tower, it just spells out one of the developers' name or something. That shit's crazy, man.
You remember the giant like chicken?
Yeah.
In Gears?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's just,
that was cool.
And
Thomas saying, yeah.
And who
like
wants
he,
toast he... was a thing.
Oh, man. Good shit, man.
Sorry, everybody. This has been another just shit show.
Go visit Jackie Chan if you're bored.
JackieChan.com/Chan.com.
Pick up some of his merch using coupon code FUNK.
Yeah. Buy a $50 box of tissues.
It's really not a coupon code. It's just it adds money to the purchase, actually.
It's the opposite.
Jackie Chan is like, UK sent you, that'll be $100.
It's what you really want from a coupon, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
To increase the overall cost.
Yeah.
They should do that. That's what we should do.
Anti-coupons?
Yeah, anti-coupons.
Yeah, that's the way to do it, yep.
I don't think... it's a good idea, I like it.
Just get really popular. Start saying that we have coupon codes for places that don't have coupon code that we don't have coupon codes for. That way, they get really upset, and we just start using that as like ways to just start like bullying people into like sponsoring us.
Use
Do
coupon
it,
code
or we'll flood your support staff
to
with
get a free audiobook.
And they'll be like, "That's not accurate."
That's FUNEQUE.
I want to get a Golden Corral sponsor.
You can be the Jeff Foxworthy of podcasts. Poor Jeff Foxworthy.
If you see a mother crying about her dead son at graduation, you might have a podcast.
What the hell is that?
It says you might be a redneck thing, but spinoff to make fun of me in the podcast.
Thomas, let's choose one more topic to close it out. We can choose one of your shits.
I mean, we already
stupid.
Did. Like,
we choose another one. You posted. You want to talk about the CIA or the lawyers?
No, I was going to look more up on the CIA thing, so I didn't end up doing
that. Oh, so he's not ready for CIA.
No.
Is this why you changed your name to CIA in the group chat?
No, that was unrelated Bane posting. That's entirely different thing.
However, he changed his name to CIA, and I changed mine to Arabic.
Yeah, that was fun.
That was on purpose.
It's really... I won't lie. Your name showing up in the group chat's very annoying.
Yeah, it reverses... Awful. It puts the punctuation at the front of it. Yep, all the text is normal, and then your name is off at the right, and then
it's ruined.
Well, just put that put that down as another thing that Islam is ruining for you.
Yeah. Oh, man. Anyway.
I'm sure it's a comprehensive list.
Fucking Poland. Some guy got the cops called on him because he has like a gunman or something. It was just a guy. It was just a plumber. He just had a plunger in his bag and people were calling
the
police.
Isn't Poland a great place?
Yeah, that's why we have an entire genre of webcomics.
Why did I say Poland?
Devoted entirely to his flag.
Thomas, this is in New York.
Oh, man, I just said Poland because he's a plumber. Wow. Whoops.
At least you didn't say Italian.
I mean, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because Mario.
Thomas, this article is like 3 words long.
Yeah.
That's the length that he's willing to put up with.
Corey, you didn't read the other one. This is perfect for you.
I didn't read this one either. I'm not going to either unless you read it. You can read it.
I mean, it's basically everything I've already said.
So what would you like to talk about this, Thomas? What do you have to say about the man who had a
plan? Basically,
we could
all he wanted to say is Polish people are criminals, and then he would shout at you for a while.
Hey, man.
It doesn't even say anything about the Poles.
Thomas, you can contact the writer. Do we want to go ahead and give the writer a call?
No, I don't want to.
Do we want to tell her that it was a plumber and not a gunman?
I think she's aware.
She might not be, though, Thomas.
You're right.
That reminds me of this raid that they did on like a British project, and they came out with all the weapons they'd collected, and like a whole bunch of them were just sticks.
Yep.
Like, it was just a pointed stick, and I was like, this is literally just a Monty Python bit.
Hey man, you gotta start somewhere.
No, they do that a lot. They like the like different police constable whatever the fucks. Yeah, anyway.
Police in Poland.
They'll post on Twitter things they got from, like, weapon confiscations for that day in that area.
Somebody had a brick.
This person had a bicycle wheel. Like, not even shitting you. That was one of them.
You could do some fucking damage with a bicycle wheel.
Yeah, the tire was still on it. And pumped. You'll be fine.
Yeah, Thomas, you put a stick on it, you spin it around, give people friction burns.
No, you get in a spinny chair, you get a friend to start making it go, then you pull it sideways, you start spinning, people will think you're up to no good because you know black magic.
Don't do that, kids. That's a felony.
That's how you summon Satan.
I don't know, Corey. Have you ever smelled rubber on fire? That's basically a chemical weapon.
It's a fucking felony, Ben.
Wait, I didn't even hear what you said.
If you take the rubber part off the wheel, is it sharp?
No.
Not really, no.
Oh.
It's just a blunt.
You're also
instrument.
Not going to go very far or very fast.
Well, I mean, you could throw it at someone's head. Have you ever thrown a bicycle
at someone's
head?
Yes, Corey, if you throw
head?
Pieces of metal at someone, you will hurt them. Surprise, surprise. Almost anything thrown at somebody with sufficient velocity is dangerous.
That's a fact, everyone. Look it up.
Yeah, honestly, yes, that is a fact.
Not one of those garbage
Not
facts.
Not one of those fune facts.
Hey, fuck you. Few facts are the best.
And the fune fact you wrote in on.
This story reminds me of how, Ben, didn't you get the cops called on you because you guys were filming in a parking lot or something?
Yeah, we were filming in a parking lot at on Centennial Campus for like 2 hours.
What'd you do?
And then, he was dealing drugs.
Yeah.
Is what he was
oh,
doing.
Okay.
Somebody said there's suspicious activity going on. We had somebody report a drug deal going on in this parking lot. And I was like, well, yeah, we're not. We're filming a
like,
bit for this.
Like,
we're filming a bit for a tech company based out of the incubator on campus. We've been here for 2 hours. What do you want from me?
Like, how white do you have to be? To
I
do
don't.
That?
You have to be really, really white. Like that
I don't
is,
understand.
That is, like, the
you
most
had a camera.
No,
who brings a camera
cameras,
to a drug deal?
Multiple cameras.
And then it's a whole bunch of white guys.
Yep.
They got everything wrong.
It's the perfect crime, really.
It's like, how sheltered do you have to be that that's what you think a drug deal looks like?
Maybe it was... Maybe that's what I should disguise drug deals as.
Absolutely. Do it.
Yeah.
Thomas, but they got the cops called on them. It didn't work.
Yeah,
you're right.
The cops,
yeah, never mind.
The cops didn't do anything, though. They didn't check anything. They're like...
Oh, like, shit, you're give right. us your licenses so we can make sure you don't have warrants. And then they left. That was it.
But you still don't want cops called on you at a drug deal.
Yeah, you generally...
Someone's gonna start sweating.
I guess.
I mean,
if Thomas is there, he's sweating anyway.
Yeah, so...
That's grease.
Honestly, yeah. It wouldn't change anything. Grease.
Yeah, to be fair, it's not technically a sweat because it is like, a synthetic.
Cop's like, why are you so nervous? I'm like, nah, this is before you showed up. Don't worry about it.
Sorry, they paid me a pizza in pizza at work, so that's all I had.
But man, I get those pizza sweats. You know what I'm talking about.
You know them pizza sweats. You get them before eating too much pizza, after eating too much pizza, and when you haven't had any pizza for a while.
And during eating pizza, so pretty much all the time.
Basically anytime. It's like anytime I haven't had pizza in 6 hours, I start sweating.
You should go to a doctor and say that, Thomas. See what he says.
He'll probably say, who are you and what are you doing in my office? You don't have an appointment. Please get out.
Go to a dentist.
So I'm trying to get that Obamacare while I still can. Get this pizza sweats checked out.
Oh, man. This is a good article, though. There is this lawyer in Miami who...
I don't believe
he was
you.
Okay. He was defending a person who was accused of arson? Just arson, yeah. I didn't know what the noun was for a second there.
Arson.
And anyway, while he was saying that... While he was saying that the car just lit on fire by itself, the man's pants lit on fire.
Oh, shit. What?
Yeah.
I gotta go to this. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Miami defense lawyer's pants burst into flames Wednesday afternoon as he began his closing arguments in front of a jury in an arson case.
I don't believe that this stuff like this happens. I feel like this kind of news, people just write it so they go to their website to get some traffic.
Honestly, that's not a crazy idea, Corey, because I'm certain that to a certain extent that happens. But maybe this is one of those guys that didn't.
Yeah, that's literally what fake news is.
Or seven, was it Note 7? Yeah, Note 7.
That's literally what fake news is. People making up news to get clicks. Yeah.
Yeah. The old definition.
Yeah.
Wait. So how did his pants catch on fire?
Because he was lying too much.
Basically, that's the joke. According to him, he said it was a faulty battery in an e-cigarette. Yeah. However, people think that he was probably just doing it for, theatrics. Without really understanding the implications. Because he's arguing that a car spontaneously combusted. If something spontaneously combusts.
Yeah,
then there's like
that would sway a jury, I guess.
Of idiots, but
it's Miami, Thomas.
It's a jury of your
fucking
peers.
Stupid.
Look, if your pants spontaneously combusted in a courtroom, and your argument is that car spontaneously combusted, I would be slightly more willing to consider your argument based solely on the fact that you did catch on fire.
Yeah.
Nah.
And honestly, if you catch on fire on purpose, like even if it wasn't spontaneous,
yeah, seriously,
and you did it like just because you believe that much, that's some dedication.
That's dedication to the cause, man.
I need someone to set it up, but me not know.
Now, don't tell me you're gonna set me on fire. Make it a surprise.
But I need to tell this person. And then immediately drink as much alcohol as I can without dying. So I forget it.
So like 4 ounces?
In case you guys were wondering, the guy was, ruled guilty. Yeah.
Of course he was. Man, his lawyer's resorting to e-cigarette-based pants-on-fire gimmicks.
Yeah.
I ain't got nothing, man. Give me your cigarette. I'm gonna set myself on fire.
I mean, looking at this guy, he looks like he's one of those $10 lawyers that you get out of a vending machine or something. You know, the billboard ones that are like, hey, you got asbestos in your house?
Did your uncle ever work on a ship?
I meant to say mesothelioma.
Whatever the fuck it is. We'll get you $10.
I'm one of those mesothelioma lawyers.
Yep. There's about 10 million of them.
Can't even mispronounce it right.
What does this even mean?
Thanks for listening.
Look, it is asbestos. It is about asbestos.
Yes, of course it's about asbestos. Corey.
Come on.
Asbestos,
have you not heard that commercial like every day?
Thomas, I haven't seen that commercial on purpose in years.
Well, yeah, nobody sees it on purpose, Corey.
The last time I saw it was on an HD TV where everything else was in HD, but for some reason this was in 144p.
Because why wouldn't they? They're not marketing to people who can see.
In fact, if you can see, it's actually a detriment.
Yeah.
It's true.
It's harder to scam people out of money when they can see what you're doing.
They were the Walker Texas Ranger commercials.
Yeah.
You guys remember that show?
No. Never heard of it, in fact. Why don't you tell me all about it while we're not doing a podcast later?
The Eyes of the Ranger upon you.
Yeah, let's go ahead and stop the podcast here, and we can listen to Corey talk about this. Goodbye, everyone.
Bye. We're just over now, I guess.
We didn't even make it to 2 hours.
Your mom didn't make it to 2 hours.